I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to take a moment and really get down to the bottom of this. Is Jake Paul a genius? Has anyone been watching his videos? Because I just got caught into this Jake Paul whirlwind, and my goodness, this guy is just almost a master of marketing. And going into this, right, just watching Jake Paul, because you know, we all love to watch mindless entertainment, mindless edumacation, mindless things to get really let the time go by. Going into watching Jake Paul's videos, like I was not going to write a thesis about this, but just looking at his titles, I was under the impression before watching him that this guy was an imbecile. You know, something one that was just careless, a jerk, a douche tuber, really just did weird pranks that no one really wanted to see. He had such a negative reputation. And then going into watching his videos, like his execution of what he's doing with his videos is the most carefully crafted, almost meticulous, like just storytelling that I've ever seen in my life. So I guess the overall point of this video is I want to go in and just kind of give a very overall just description of why his channel is kind of just dominating. And maybe there's something where us as, you know, investors or people trying to grow a business or just YouTubers trying to grow our channels, we can go in and look at Jake Paul's success and what he's doing and maybe incorporate that to our own life. Hi, my name is Fly Stewie. You're watching the Uneducated Investor Podcast, baby. I miss doing that. I really do. Make sure you hit the like button because that's how we grow in this YouTube algorithm world. And guys, let's get better investing together. This podcast connects investing to pop culture. And we're talking about Jake Paul. Because if you didn't know, he is one of the biggest YouTubers in the world, and he has been ever since he exploded and came out from Vine and now is in the YouTube realm. Now this guy's like a 20 something year old. He's been dominating, living in a lovely place. I think it's California, and he runs a team called Team 10, and he's backed by one of the best investors of our time. That's Gary Vaynerchuk, is actually one of the investors giving him money so he can have a lavish mansion and build crazy pranks and get a return for his investors. So with a place like Team 10 and this world that we live in that's run by personal brands, Jake Paul is at the highest level of creating a personal brand. So I just want to go through his YouTube channel and really show you guys what I'm talking about. Right now, as you can see, we're on YouTube right here. This is my channel. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. You know, it definitely supports the channel. But when we look at Jake Paul, the first thing that's Jake Paul's YouTube channel, one of the first thing that's ever gonna, you know, really stuck out to you is he has 20 million subscribers and over, wait for it, 6 billion views. 6 billion views. Like, that is absolutely ridiculous. And he really started recording like videos on a consistent basis on YouTube probably around 2016, 17, 18, around that time. When we think about entertainment and the reason why people really watch something, there's really two things that really come to mind, you know? Those things are, does that entertainment, that piece of art, that piece of television you're watching, does that have a good story? And does it have great characters? And when you're looking at his titles, he has done something so interesting. I don't know if you've caught it yet, but essentially what Jake has done is he turned himself into a real life character. You know, normally we used to watch dramas, then we went more to reality TV, and now it's like almost at a new level. It's almost like, I would define Jake as like a real reality TV person because he is basically creating this extravagant life that is almost viable and makes you question that. So what I mean by that is recently he's been getting super amounts of press because he got married to another YouTuber called Tana Managu, I think that's her name. And his titles around this Tana Managu thing, it's just like, it's just baiting other YouTubers to really talk about him. So when we start to really look at the titles around the videos about Jake Paul. He knows how to basically use your curiosity. He knows exactly what you're thinking, and he creates videos around those topics in such a crazy way. So what I mean by this is, we know that Jake Paul is getting married, right, to a girl named Tana Montague, a YouTuber. And look at the titles he has around it. He says, "I bought my fiance the car of her dreams. We actually got engaged." The next title of the video is, "Our first fight as a couple." And then the next is, "To the people who think we aren't actually engaged," right? Then it starts getting a little more hilarious. I will say that, you know, "We're canceling the wedding" is one title. The next one is, "We got married." The next one is, "Here's the truth about our relationship." The next one is, "I got caught cheating on my wife." And it's just these videos that, like, if you're someone who's not invested in this wedding and you're looking for the downfall of Jake Paul, he's gonna get you with a, "Oh, they finally caught him cheating. I knew he was not serious about being faithful. We got him." But then you click on the video and it's just clickbait. It's literally just clickbait. Barely anything about cheating. It's just like him chilling with a girl at one point. And he has mastered the ability to turn himself into a story. Like, there's a lot of things on YouTube we do to actually drive engagement. So one of them is talking about the most recent things that are happening on YouTube. But with his content, he's been able now to actually use himself and generate news through his own content by basically manipulating controversy. Now, this is something that's really interesting that I've been watching with Jake Paul. It's like, he knows he has haters, and he's so good at making his haters do the things that he wants them to do. So whenever he drops a video about him getting married, he knows that no one's gonna believe it. So the first thing that happens, he drops a video, "I'm getting married to this Tana girl," after he just had a girlfriend, I think it was last 2 years. All these news places start covering it. All these other YouTubers start covering it. And because of YouTube's algorithms, it's basically sending all this traffic to Jake Paul's way, because people are searching Jake Paul so much on YouTube. And when you search Jake Paul on YouTube, just his name, he dominates the feed of videos from his channel. He is amazing at just YouTube marketing. So as YouTubers, what can we really do? Or as business people, what can we really do if we're trying to kind of mirror almost a Jake Paul business model? I say the first thing that we really got to understand is how to make a great story and how to create a great character. So of course, if you're, you know, a business and you're selling cookies online, or maybe you're knitting sweaters online, you're selling them to people around you, if you're knitting sweaters, you got to create a story behind you. You know, you got to create a reason, like a story that like makes people feel like they almost know you. You know, the storytelling is so almost underrated and kind of the cheap entertainment landscape that we live in, you know. But with a great story, Jake Paul proves that you can really break through and get people's attention in this noisy world that we live in. Another thing that we can really learn from Jake Paul is, haters are just motivation, you know. It's so interesting that Jake Paul is one of the most controversial people in the world. And he almost uses that for fuel for himself to go farther. You see, he knows that every time he puts out a video, a lot of people just hate him. They think of him as a douche or a jerk. And he knows that perception he has, and he plays into it in a healthy way. You know, yes, Jake Paul's a jerk. Of course he's gonna cheat on his wife. Boom, he creates a YouTube video that says, "I got caught cheating on my wife," because he knows that's what people expect of him. And then it's just complete clickbait, and it has nothing to do with that. You see, it's something so funny. He almost embraces people to hate on him and uses that controversy to actually propel his content and make something engaging for the viewer. Like, I can't really think of too many YouTubers that have done such a great job of sitting down, thinking, and it's so meticulous. He literally is almost planning his wedding, his divorce, his first kid. Yeah, he has a mini Jake Paul on his channel now, which is crazy. They're planning the pets they got. They're planning every single fight they're gonna have. It's like his real life and his story and his YouTube are all in one, and he's just knows how to package it in the most consumable way for an audience. So I would say don't feel bad for the hate, baby. Embrace that in whatever business or investing route you're going to, and do the things that really help you grow. I'm gonna be looking at Jake Paul in the future because I just find his channel absolutely fascinating. Like, it's just crazy. I was expecting this guy to just, I don't know, make fart jokes or some nonsense, but his channel is hilarious. I can't believe I'm saying that, but I'm a Jake Pauler. I think that's what he calls his audience. Just complete jokes. Anyways, this is the Uneducated Investor Podcast. Feel free to leave a like and subscribe. And we, my friends, we gotta take off, baby. Easy.